And his disciples asked him, saying, "Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Then Jesus answered, "Neither have this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day. The night cometh when no man can work. As long as I'm in the world, I am the light of the world." When he had thus spoken, he spat on the ground, made clay of the spittle. He anointed the eyes of the blind man with the clay, concluded in seven, and said unto him, "Go, wash in the pool of Siloam," which is by interpretation sent. He went his way therefore, and washed, and came seeing. Thank you so much. Tell your neighbor, there's nobody like Jesus.
There's nobody like Jesus.
There's nobody like Jesus. Beloved, every now and then, the God that we serve will allow us to come across somebody that's an exception to the rule. Every now and then, God, in his providence, will allow us to meet somebody that's unique, unusual, and uncomparable. Whenever you find yourself in the company of somebody like that, you really ought to give God some praise, because you are in the midst of receiving a blessing. If you look throughout the history of humanity, God has been known for raising up individuals that are unique, unusual, and uncomparable. For instance, in the arena of football, my favorite sport, I grew up playing football in the streets of Memphis. The touchdown was from light pole to light pole, and if you got close to the sidewalk, we called it sideline pop. You got tackled on the concrete. And football was my first girlfriend that I ever had. I love football, and my favorite player was Jerry Rice. Jerry Rice is uncomparable, because there's nobody in the NFL that have caught more passes than Jerry Rice. There's nobody that have caught more receiving yards than Jerry Rice. There's nobody that have caught more receiving touchdowns than Jerry Rice. I tell you why. It's because Jerry Rice is uncomparable. Let me try another door here. In the arena of basketball, Michael Jordan, he's uncomparable. Talk to me, somebody. Kobe Bryant, the Black Mamba, doesn't have more rings than Michael Jordan. LeBron James, who declares himself to be the king, does not have more rings than Michael Jordan. Russell Westbrook, Kevin Durant, Carmelo Anthony, Charles Barkley, Patrick Ewing, Reggie Miller, Isaiah Thomas, none of them have more rings than Michael Jordan. And I'll tell you why. Because Michael Jordan, come on, help me, he's uncomparable. All right. Well, in the arena of entertainment, Michael Jackson is uncomparable. You will help me, won't you? Michael Jackson, beloved, Beyonce hasn't sold more records than Michael Jackson. Jay-Z has not sold more records than Michael Jackson. Drake, Lil Wayne, Birdman, Nicki Minaj, Curtis Blow, LL Cool J, Frankie Beverly, and the Maze, Charlie Wilson, Luther Vandross, Freddie Jackson, the OJs, the Four Top, and the Temptation. None of them have sold more reckless than Michael Jackson, I tell you why, Michael Jackson is uncomparable. All right, but if you didn't catch me in football, you didn't catch me in basketball, you hadn't caught me in entertainment, then maybe you'll catch me when I start talking about the Lord. How many of you know, beloved, that Jesus the Christ is uncomparable? You don't hear me today. Buddha died, but he never got back up. Confucius died, but he never got back up. Elijah Muhammad died, but never got back up. Malcolm X died, but never got back up. Martin Luther King died, but he never got back up. Nigga Evers died, Shirley Chisholm died, Fannie Lou Hamer died, Tupac died, Biggie Smalls died, Adam died, Noah died, Abraham died. Come on, talk to me somebody. Joshua died, David died, Solomon died, Hosea, Jordan, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi, they all died. But when Jesus died, you ought to tap your name and say, neighbor, but he didn't stay dead long, because early Sunday morning, when my Baptist folk get in the house, he got up with all power in his hand, shake your neighbor's hand, and say, neighbor, Jesus is uncomparable. I came to tell somebody today that there's nobody like my Jesus. Anybody gonna help me preach in this house? Oh, beloved, this is a personal testimony for me, y'all. I thank the Lord that I am a child of God. Do I have a witness here? That's the reason I can sing it for myself. He walks with me.
Yeah.
He talks with me.
Yeah.
He tells me that I am his own and the joy that we share.
Yeah.
As we tarry there. None other have ever known there's nobody, y'all, that's like Jesus. And let me tell you, if there's any text in the Bible, Dr. Lord, that can teach us, train us, and tutor us about the fact that there's nobody like Jesus, Dr. Buckley, I believe it has to be this story of how Jesus gives sight to a man born blind. Can I tell you real quick before I leave you how the text, Dr. Jackson, it proved to us that there's nobody, Dr. Harris, like Jesus. I tell you how it is. It's because, number one, Jesus can see your condition. Someone ought to help me here. He's a God that can see your condition. The text said, as he passed by, he saw a man that was born blind. The text said blind from his birth. Notice the man didn't see Jesus. But I'm shouting today because when I couldn't see the Lord, I thank God he was yet able to see me. I was having some witnesses in this house. I can look back over my own life going on 41 years, and whether you believe it or not, I've had some good days. I've had some bad days. Some weary days. I've had some bumps and bruises on my back. I've had some problems on my plate, some struggles on my shoulder, some trials, some tests, and some tears treading me on my trail. And there have been some times in my life when I couldn't see Jesus. But can I testify real quick to y'all in this house? The reason that I'm still breathing is not because I saw the Lord, but I'm here because the Lord was yet able to see me. And somebody here can testify that as long as Jesus can see you, everything got to be all right. Y'all ought to help me preach it here. My son is about 6 months years old, and every now and then Junior will start crying. And he'll look around and he'll see me. He's crying and he's waiting on me to step in, but I won't. I tell you why I won't, because I'm looking at him. Do I have a witness in his house? And what Junior don't know is what I know is he don't have to worry about daddy showing up on time. But Because just as long as daddy can see you, I know exactly when to step in and work that thing out. Can I talk to somebody here today? Beloved, you don't have to worry if Jesus will show up on time. Just long as you know the Lord is watching you, no matter what you're going through, he'll show up and take care of the business. He saw the man. Now watch this real quick. I got to go through this